the we encourage strongly that the licensee form some kind of community advisory board in which they could.
Let me, I apologize, I just don't have a whole lot of time. I understand all that, we chatted community advisory. That is not satisfactory to me, because advice can be rejected.
Mm-hmm.
So my question to you all is, should the states themselves, who have to deal with the consequence of the decommissioning process, have a real, and I understand real is not a technical term, but be part of the process such that if what is negotiated between the industry and the NRC is not satisfactory, that will not happen. To be a real player in the process. Should the states have that type of authority? Mrs. McFarland, very briefly.
I think it depends on the specific situation in the state. I think that there are more interests at stake than just the governor of the state. There are local interests as well.
Absolutely.
Those need to be represented somehow.
But in our democratic society, it is the state government that ends up, you know, getting elected to do those things. Let me just say this, because I think I'm probably not going to get a clear answer from any of you. This is a very, very important issue. I think your rules right now are not satisfactory. I think you do not give enough input, you don't give enough power, if you like, in the decision-making power to the people of the states. I would hope, and you and I will chat about this, Ms. McFarland, that we will change the rules as they are currently constituted. If you do not change the rules, I will introduce legislation to make sure that states do have that authority. Madam Chair, thank you.
Thank you, Senator. And you can count on my support for that, because I've got decommission. I think Massachusetts has one coming as well. Senator Sessions.
Thank you. Well, the government, we don't want to get the government out, I assume, of solar, auto, ethanol, wind powers.
How about oil?
Oil. There's not much in it except they're restricted.
Except $6 billion a year.
That's a disputed fact.
Okay.
As to whether or not that's any special tax break or whether it's just a normal tax situation all corporations have. Okay. Well, I would like to see Bellefonte done in Alabama. I don't know what Vermont does. They sued Vermont Yankee multiple times. I guess they finally just gave up and closed the plant. That's all right. Vermont doesn't want to have their electricity produced using carbon fuels or whatever, so be it. I'd like to see clean nuclear power be used more around the country. Now, I raise this concern because I'm really worried about it. I think all of you are aware of the situation we have concerning a constriction of nuclear power. And if states now get to second guess your regulatory powers, and maybe they have a right to do so, but if they jump in and double up on the cost of closing a plant or opening a plant, it's just one more burden that makes it even less likely that we'll have an expansion of nuclear power, and more likely that we will see this decline continue. So I'm worried about it. Ms. Sabinicki, you've been on the commission for some time, and you've observed these issues develop. Would you give your thoughts to us and share your thoughts with us about what might be contributing to the erosion of nuclear power generation and the failure of new plants to get started that we thought would be started?
Well, I think, as is well acknowledged by economic experts, the situation of abundant natural gas, while good for the United States in many ways, does affect the economics of both new nuclear but also current nuclear. And so from the regulator standpoint, although we don't control any of those macroeconomic factors, I think that our pledge as a commission is to make certain that we do the most disciplined sort of analysis and work, so that we are only imposing regulations that we've thoroughly analyzed and justified.
Is it possible that these regulatory factors and, let's say, a lack of final certainty over waste disposal and Yucca Mountain and cumulative cost of compliance are affecting the future of nuclear power?
I support the commission's action to address the court's remand to us of our waste confidence decision. I think that the commission and the agency staff are taking quick and responsible action to address the deficiencies that the court identified, which were not the entirety of the rule that we had put forward, but the court asserted and found that our analysis and evaluation lacked certain points. We're remedying those specific deficiencies, and as the chairman has noted, although we have delayed our schedule by 1 month, we still continue to push forward very aggressively.
Well, it's worse than that. The court hammered the commission and Congress and all for failure to meet this and declared it was an absolute violation of multiple requirements of law. And it goes to the very core of who writes law in America. Congress passed laws. We chose this site. It's been authorized and directed. Fees have been collected in billions of dollars, and very little action has been done. Wouldn't you agree that the court's promise was the court's decision was a real critique of the failure to act on the congressionally approved Yucca Mountain site?
Yes, on the matter of Yucca Mountain, the court's language was was unequivocal and was very, very strong. But again, we've taken actions to address the writ of mandamus.
Will that be completed in what time?
Well, we are providing monthly reports to this committee. We do not have the team of NRC experts who will address that work fully assembled. I believe the last I heard last week, we have 75% of the experts assembled. And as the Chairman McFarlane noted, I think they still anticipate it would take approximately 1 year.
I understand she's talked about that previously, but I think if you need to reprogram money, you should ask for it. It just comes down at some point to a constitutional question. Will the government of the United States execute the laws established by the duly elected Congress? You have a duty to do that. Not one member of the United States Senate, some powerful senator, ought to be able to block what's been decided by the majority of Congress. I believe if you're seeking investments to build a nuclear plant in the future, the fact that we have failed to have an approved disposal site is a factor, how much I don't know, in weighing against building and going forward with investments in a plant. If you're not sure that that will ever be affected, then ever solved, it could reduce your confidence that you can have the waste disposal disposed of as required. You will be less confidence in investing. How many, Ms. McFarland, plants are in license or re-license process now?
In licensing process? We have nine combined license reviews underway. Many of them have been slowed down in part because there are delays in the design certifications for the plants, and those delays were requested by the vendors themselves. And there are no firm construction plans right now for those, including Bellefonte.
Right.
But we do have five reactors under construction actively in the U.S., and we'll be seeing most likely the completion of the Watts Bar 2 unit.
So you take the TVA's Watts Bar 2.
Yep.
The two at Vogtle.
Two at Vogtle and two at Summer in South Carolina.
Okay. And the Vogtle and Summer are entirely new?
They're entirely new designs. Yep. The Westinghouse AP1000.
How would you describe, I know you visited the Vogtle plant mm-hmm. recently as part of your inspecting tour. I hope they don't complain about that travel. I think that's good travel. Go and observe the plant and see what's going on. Was it your observation that these plants with a new design, the AP1000, with passive cooling, so if all power is shut off, you can still allow the water to cool the system and prevent disaster, would that be an improvement on the Fukushima design and avoid some of the dangers that occurred there? And how would that?
Passive systems are certainly better than active systems that have to be activated. So those passive systems are an improvement.
For people who are listening, would you describe how the passive system would work?
In light of the time, I'm going to take that one for the record.
Okay. Well, do you feel like that these plants that are on the new ones that are moving forward could help the United States be a leader in a modern nuclear plant and set an example for the world as well as our country?
Well, it's our job at the Nuclear Regulatory Commission to ensure that the operating plants and the plants under construction are moving along safely, the plants are operating safely and securely, we're protective of public health and safety. It's not our job to prognosticate on the safety of the health of the nuclear industry or what's best in terms of nuclear policy or energy policy. We leave that up to Congress and the administration.
Well, you have a role to play in it, and excessive regulation at this time of real competition from low-cost natural gas that is a fairly clean carbon fuel, but not as clean as nuclear power. I think that the scales could be tilted in a way that we could see a collapse in the future of nuclear power. And I think you have to be aware that there are ramifications from your decisions. Thank you for your work. I think all of you have tried to do the right thing for the country.